Hello, everyone. In this video, you'll learn how to download your search results in Dialog. We'll see how to either download all of your results or only the records that you've selected using what's called Export Save. I'll show you how to select from Dialog's wide range of file formats and how to choose the content or parts of the records that you want to download. So let's get started. Here I've run a search and we're on the results list, ready to download some records. I could click Download All and get all of these records at once, but often you just want some of the records from your list, and for that you'd use this link here, Export Save. It's just a little ways under Download All, and the steps are just the same for both, except that with Export Save, you have to first select which records you want. So I'm going to pick a couple of these. And now I go over to export/save, and notice as I pause here, I get a pop-up listing a number of file formats to choose from. I could select one right from here by clicking on it, but instead, I'll click on Export Save and use this blue pop-up. The first thing I'm going to do is check this box here that says Deselect Items When Done, because I don't want these records to stay selected after this download. That's just my preference. If you wanted to get these records again as part of your next download in this session, then leave this box unchecked. Now you see two drop-down boxes. In this one, you can choose what file type or file format you want to download in. The default is PDF, but I can choose RTF, which is similar to a Word type document and it opens in Word. If you use EndNote or one of these citation managers, you'll know how to use this file format. You can get spreadsheets or XML if you're doing some kind of post-processing, and Dialog offers all of that as choices and more. For now, I'm just going to leave this at PDF. The second drop-down box is where you choose how much content you want from these records. The default choice is results listing only, but that's very similar to what we've already seen in the results list, so I'm going to want something with more information. And Dialog offers several standard choices. We could get just the bibliographic type info with brief citation, or we can add the abstract with citation abstract. If you see full text here, that indicates that at least some of the records in this set are available as full text. Custom is an interesting option that you may want to explore, and I'll show you that in a little while, but for now, I'm going with Citation Abstract. You can check this box for quick, keywords in context, then at the bottom of each record, you'll get an extra section showing all of your search terms with a few words around them for context. These four boxes here, I like to keep checked, but you can pick any of them or none. Recent searches means that when you download your records, you'll get a table with all of the searches that you just did up at the top. Because sometimes you want to not only get your records, you also want to document the steps that you took to get them. So I like to leave this checked. Check Show Hit Highlighting if you want to have your search terms highlighted wherever they appear in the downloaded part of your record. You can get all the highlighting in yellow or choose Multicolor to see each of your terms highlighted in a different color. Now I've made my choices and I'm ready to click Continue. And because I'm using what they call a transactional account, I get a price preview showing what these records will cost. If your Dialog agreement includes unlimited access to those databases, you wouldn't need this preview because you wouldn't be charged for the downloads. But that's something you can ask your Dialog representative about. Now, at this point, I still have not incurred any cost. There's no charge for searching in Dialog. And when I see this preview, if it's a number that I need to talk to my client about or get some kind of approval, then I could just close this box by clicking the X, and I still have not spent anything. But this amount looks fine to me, so I click Continue. I'm just going to turn off previews for now, and the download is done. I'm in Chrome, so I can get to the record by clicking this icon that just appeared at the bottom left. In Firefox or in the Microsoft browser, you'd get a pop-up asking if you want to open it or save it. Here in Chrome, actually it's already saved to my default download folder with a sort of generic file name based on today's date, but I tend to go ahead and open it, look at it, and then save it again manually in a folder that I want to find it in with some name that I'll recognize later. So let's have a look at this report we just created. You see the table of contents actually works as a set of links. If I click on this title, it jumps right down to that part of the record, which is very useful if you have a long list of titles. Under the table of contents, we have the recent searches. I only did the one today, but if you did a complex series of searches, you'd be glad to have them all here as part of your report. And here are the records themselves. Now, each and every bit of information here is important to a lot of people. But what if you don't want all of this? Maybe you don't care about the ISSN number, or you don't need to have what city the publisher is in. That's why we offer custom formats, and I'll show you how that works. Back on the results list, I'll select another record, go to Export Save, and in the blue pop-up, this time I'll pick PDF with custom format. And when I click Continue, I get a screen that lists all the individual parts of the record. And maybe I just want abstract. I'll also check author, although that's already included in publication information, which is already checked by default. I'll check database so I know where I got it. And publication information already includes things like the title and author and the journal name and date, so I think that's enough for me, really, at least in some cases. I can click Continue now, and I'll get the download. But first, I kind of like this short selection of fields, and I may want to use it again. So I'll check Save My Selections for Future Use. This opens a box where I can give this template a name. I'll call it My Short Format. Now I click Continue, and here we have it, a record with a nice short format that works for me. Now that I've saved that template, I can pick another record, go to Export Save, and instead of these other formats, I'll pick Saved Template, and then My Short Format. And that lets me get any record very quickly in the exact format that I want. Once you pick the way you want to download, Dialog will remember your choices for the rest of the session, or until you change it, so the whole process really is very fast. I realize it seems slower in my demonstration because I've been explaining it as we go along, so let's do one more. It's really just this. Pick a record, click Export Save. These boxes are fine, so I click Continue, and I'm done. So that's it. In this video, you learned the basic steps of selecting records for export and save, and downloading them in any kind of format and content that you choose, from the most concise to the full text. With downloading, you've completed the full workflow on Dialog, selecting your databases, planning and constructing your search, making use of the Dialog syntax, narrowing your results as needed, working with the results list, and getting your records, along with the information you need, using Dialog. Here at Dialog, we're proud to be a part of your work and happy to help make your research better, smarter, and easier in any way we can. Thanks for using Dialog, and enjoy the rest of your day.